recognize this one? All right, get my band rolling here. Does he even know this one? This was written in 1970. I was 1 year old in 1970. It's going to my age. Do you remember this one? Put your hand in the hand of the man who steals the water. Put your hand in the hand of the man who calms the sea. Well, take a look at yourself, and you can look at others differently. But put in your hand in the hand of a man from Galilee. My mama taught me how to pray before I reached the age of 7. When I'm down on my knees, that's when I'm closest to heaven. Daddy lived his life with 2 boys and a wife. Well, you do what you must do. But he showed me nothing what it takes to get me through. Oh, yeah. But put your hand in the hand of a man who steals the water. Put your hand in the hand of a man who calms the sea. Well, take a look at yourself, and you can look at others differently. But put in your hand in the hand of a man from Galilee. Oh, yeah. Y'all can clap on beat. Church, I sung this morning, could clap on beat.
Come on, everybody. Oh, yeah.
We're going to have a good time.
Oh, yeah. Here we go now.
Put your hand in the hand of a man who steals the water. Put your hand in the hand of a man. But putting your hand in the hand of a man from Galilee. Oh, yeah. But putting your hand in the hand of a man who steals the water. Come on and put your hand in the hand of a man who calms the sea. Well, take a look at yourself, and you can look at others differently. But putting your hand in the hand of a man from Galilee. Putting your hand in the hand of a man from Galilee. Oh, yeah. But putting your hand in the hand of a man from Galilee. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, great job, everybody. Great job, great job.
Fell in love with this song about 2 years ago. See if you know this song.
I love you, Lord, for your mercy never fails me. All my days I've been held in your hand. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, oh, I will say of the goodness of God. Faithful. All my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire. In the darkest night, you are close like no other. I've known you as a father. I've known you as a friend. And I have lived in the goodness of God. Oh, you have been faithful. All my life you have been so, so good.
Southern Indiana, and the praise team got up and started doing that song. And I mean, I go on the front. Hold on. Behave yourself. The band has not been working right today. I'm going to fire the band, okay? So I was on the front row of this little church, you know, and they started doing that song. And I'm just weeping, and I've got my hands raised, praising God. And I finished the service that day and called my wife. I said, "You're not going to believe this. I heard this song. I love it." And I said, "It's called Goodness of God." She said, "You knucklehead, I played for that song for you 3 months ago and you didn't like it." So there you go. But I just love that song. All my life you've been faithful. All my life you have been good. What a wonderful, wonderful God we serve. Amen?
Yeah.
Amen. Thank you for letting me come tonight. I do apologize, my wife not being here. She had some issues this past week. We usually come to Capri either the Sunday evening before our cruise or after our cruise. We take the Singing at Sea cruise, and it's a working vacation for us. We sing on the cruise, we MC, we do the Newlywed game at least one day on the cruise, and so we drove down from Ohio. We live around Cincinnati. We drove down, I forget what day it was now. It's been a blur. A week ago yesterday, we drove down, And she had an episode in the hotel room. She's a long-haul COVID survivor, and she also has lupus. And so I think her being in the car that long really did a number on her. So she woke up Saturday morning in Georgia in a hotel room and just having some lung issues and breathing issues. She got on the ship, and she rested for a couple days and kind of got adjusted to everything, and then she started having eye issues. She has lupus, and so she has extreme dry eyes, and she has scratched her cornea about 7 times in the past year and a half. And she woke up Wednesday morning, her eye was swelling, and we have vaporizer in every room of the house where we live, and I took one on the ship with us, and she was working with that eye, and got where she was able to function, and Thursday was a little worse, and so I didn't want to take any chances. So when we got off the ship yesterday, I put her and our daughter on a plane and flew them home, so they're home resting right now. She is, and I asked her. I said, "Well," she said, "I'm awake." She said, "But I'm not out of bed yet." I said, "That's totally fine. You stay right where you're at." So she sends her apologies that she can't be with me tonight. So keep her in your prayers if you would. I appreciate that very much, but. Every time we come to Capri, of course, I've known Steve a long time. I know his wonderful dad. We always sing at his church every April. We go to his church and his his grandpa, that was just a great, great man. I just thought the world of him. And one of the greatest. I was honored to sing at his funeral several years ago. But every time we come here, we talk about our grandbabies. And this is no exception, because I'm going to tell you about my grandbabies. Our 3 granddaughters are the most beautiful children you probably have ever seen in your life. And they're just beautiful. In fact, our oldest granddaughter called me today while I was driving down 75 and said, "Baby, can I call you back?" Because she wanted to FaceTime me because she wanted me to see her medals, and she's in gymnastics competition. And her team come in first place today. But our 3 grandbabies, our oldest is 8 years old, and she's in 3rd grade. Her name is Charlotte. We call her Cha-Cha. Then our middle granddaughter, she is 7 years old. She got her ears pierced yesterday. And her name is Sophia. And we call her Sophie Girl. And our 3rd and youngest, she just turned 4 back in April. Her name is Harper. We're calling her Pippi, okay? So you get all the names now. So right before Pippi turned 4 years old last August, I had all the kids over, and I'm that Poppy, because that's who I am, I'm Poppy. I'm that Poppy that I'm in the floor with them. If they want to paint my fingernails, I let them do that. If they want to curl my hair, I let them do that. Whatever the girls want to do, Poppy is the one they go to, okay? So I'm in the floor with the girls, and I looked at Pippi, and I said, "Baby," I said, "I can't believe you're going to be 4 years old." And she said, "Happy birthday, Poppy." I said, "No, baby, it's not going to be my birthday. It's going to be your birthday." I said, "But you're so beautiful." She said, "Poppy, am I beautiful?" I said, "Yes, baby, you're beautiful." And I said, "You know what?" I said, "You know Jesus made you." She said, "Poppy, did Jesus make me?" I said, "Yes, baby." And her Mimi, Yvonne, was sitting right next to her. She said, "Well, Poppy, did Jesus make Mimi too?" I said, "Yes, baby, Jesus made Mimi too." So she touched me on the face. She said, "Poppy, did Jesus make you?" I said, "Well, yeah, a long time ago." She said, "He sure is getting better, isn't he?" I said, "Yes, he is. Yes, he is, matter of fact." So we were raised on the hymns, okay? I was raised a Baptist, okay? Yvonne was raised non-instrumental Church of Christ. Her dad was a non-instrumental Church of Christ preacher. So we were both raised on the hymns, okay? We love the newer songs. You just heard Goodness of God. But we love the old hymns, okay? So a couple years ago, we decided we wanted to introduce our grandbabies to some of the hymns. So we got a really cool arrangement on this next song. I promise you, you've heard this song, but probably never like this. So here's what I tell adults. If you don't like the way we do this song, it'll be over in about 4 minutes, okay? So you just bear with me, and if I get my band to roll it, because it started to play a second ago, but now we're going to get the real one. So here we go. Like this.
Up, up, gonna fly away, gonna fly away someday. Up, up, gonna fly away, gonna fly away someday. Gonna fly away, gonna fly away someday. Gonna fly away, gonna fly away someday. Sun bright morning, when the swap is over, I'll fly away to our home on God's celestial shore. I'll And like a bird from prison bars have flown, I'll fly away, oh glory, I'll fly away. I'm gonna fly away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away. Just a few more weary days and then I'll fly away to a land where joy shall never end.
Here's what they'd say to me.
Well, I'm going to sing an old bluegrass song. I'm not going to do it bluegrass style, but this song is a bluegrass song.
Gain the world and lose my soul. I don't want to lose my soul, my soul.
I'd rather be in a deep, dark grave and know that my poor soul was saved, than to live in this world in a house of gold and deny my
saying that Hank Williams had wrote that song. I got back to the table to sell CDs, and a guy came back there for 45 minutes and stood there and gave me the complete biography of Hank Williams. Everything he ever wrote, what he had for breakfast every day, every place he lived, a lot of information I didn't need to know about Hank. But anyway, while I'm on the subject of that song, about 4 or 5 months ago now, I was visiting my mother. My mom's in a nursing home in southern Indiana, where I'm originally from. And I was sitting in a room with her, and activities director came in, and she said, your mom, my mom's nickname is Cookie, okay? Nicknames, okay? She said, Cookie says you're a singer. I said, well, yeah. She said, well, maybe you'd like to come and do a program one day for the residents. I said, you name the time, and I'll be here. And so a few months later, she came back in. She said, how about this particular Thursday? I said, well, if my wife can't come with me, I'll come alone. She said, great. We'll just bill it as gospel program. I said, that'll work fine. And so I got there that day, got all my stuff set up, you know, down in the dining room at 2 o'clock for the gospel program. And activities director came and found me. She had a big old stack of posters with my picture on, okay? And I was getting ready to go down the hallway. I was going to invite every single resident. I was going to everybody's room, invite everybody. And I was heading down. She said, oh, I forgot to tell you. In room 207, Miss Beulah, she's a huge gospel music fan. She might know who you are. I said, okay. So I get down. I finally get to room 207. There's Miss Beulah sitting in the room. And I go in there. I said, Miss Beulah, I want to invite you to the gospel program today at 2 o'clock in the dining room. And she looked up at me. And I said, would maybe you might know who I am? She said, no. I said, okay. I said, well, I hear you're a gospel music fan. She said, oh, yeah, been forever. I said, well, good. I said, maybe you, have you ever seen those Bill Gaither videos, the Gaither videos? She said, I've got every single one. My daughter bought me an entire collection. I've got them all on DVD. I've got every one of them. Now, I'm on about 17 of those DVDs. I said, well, good. I said, do you recognize me? She said, no. I said, okay. I said, well, have you ever been to the big national quartet convention? That's where all the groups get together for one full week and everybody sings. And I said, have you ever been to the quartet convention? She said, I went every year. She said, it was in Birmingham, then it moved to Memphis, then it moved to Nashville, then it was in Louisville, and that's in Pigeon Forge. I was on there about 25 years. I said, well, good, you've been to the quartet convention. I said, do I look familiar to you? She said, no. I said, well, who was some of your favorite groups? She said, well, I love the Spear family. She said, I love the Blackwood Brothers, the Statesmen. She said, but my all-time favorite quartet was the Kingsmen. I was with the Kingsmen for 10 years. 10 years. I said, well, good, you like the Kingsmen. She said, oh, yeah. I said, do you know who I am? She said, no. So, well, I said, well, Miss Beulah, make sure you're down there at 2 o'clock. I said, we're going to do some new songs, some old songs, maybe some Christmas songs. And I handed her a poster with my picture on it. And I said, are you sure you don't know who I am? She said, I don't know who you are, but if you go down to the front desk, they'll tell you who you are. So just when you think somebody might recognize you, they don't. And that's okay. I tell you what, it's okay if I ask Stephen to come up. Why don't you come up and get on the piano with me? This guy is super talented, in case you didn't know. And in our ministry, you know, I play drums, but that won't really help anything. But so when I get around a musician that can play guitar or piano, I'll put it this way. My daddy would say, you got a good horse, you need to ride him. Okay, so I'm going to ask Stephen to play is it E flat? Is that what he did it in? Okay. Yeah. I got to sing this at Lisa Marie Presley's funeral last year. I was asked to go with the Blackwood Brothers and fill in with them for her service.
Oh Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds thy hands have made, I see the stars and I hear the rolling thunder.
Can you sing the chorus with me?
Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art.
most people leave out. In my church, we never did this verse, ever did this verse.
And when I think of God, His Son not sparing, sent Him to die, was scarce, but a scarce can take it in. There it is. That on the cross, my burden gladly bearing, He bled and died to take away my sin.
When Christ shall come,
when Christ shall come, with shout of acclamation, and takes me home, oh, what joy shall fill my heart. Then I shall bow in humble adoration, and there proclaim, oh my God, how great Thou art. Then sing to my soul,
information in our heads. Can I get an amen on that? For me, it's song lyrics. So my wife Yvonne, she says, these groups call you to fill in because you know the old songs. I said, I know the old songs better than the songs that I'm doing tonight. So thank you, Stephen. Give him another hand, will you? I want to do a new song for you.
Afraid to lose, I feel qualified for what you're calling me to do. Lord, with your strength, I've got no excuse, 'cause broken people are exactly who you use. So give me faith like Daniel in the lion's den. Give me hope like Moses in the wilderness. Give me a heart like David, Lord, be my defense, that I can face my giants with confidence. You called a shepherd boy, you made him a king, so I'm gonna trust you and give you everything. I'll be a conqueror, 'cause you'll fight for me. Be a champion, claiming your victory. So give me faith like Daniel in the lion's den. Give me hope like Moses in the wilderness. Give me a heart like David, Lord, be my defense, that I can face my challenge. giants with confidence. Gonna sing and shout and shake the walls. Won't stop until I see them fall. I'm gonna stand a step by the wind you call. Jesus, Jesus. I'm gonna sing and shout and shake the walls. Won't stop until I see them fall. I'm gonna stand a step by the wind you call. Jesus, to give me faith like Daniel in the lion's den. Give me hope like Moses in the wilderness. Give me a heart like David, Lord, be my defense. So I can face my giants with confidence. Oh! In the wilderness, give me a heart like David, Lord, be my defense. I can face my giants with confidence. I can face my giants with confidence.
Isn't that a great song? Man, what a great song. I want to share a song with you that this song came in my life in year 2000. I was traveling with the Kingsmen at the time, and we were preparing for a new recording that was going to be coming out, in 2000. And I had lost my dad. My dad had passed away in 1999. And so this new album that the Kingsmen were working on, they had all the songs chosen. And back in those days, we had very little input of what we actually recorded. And all the songs were chosen. They had they would basically say, okay, we're going to sing this song. Brian, you'll do the verse on this. You'll do the both verses, and you'll lead this. And so that's kind of how it was. And so the song chosen for this new recording was a good song for me. But the gentleman that was going to produce the album was going to ride the bus that weekend, and he had his keyboard set up in the back lounge of the bus, and we were going to rehearse this particular day. So we would go in the studio and be a little more efficient getting things done. And he got on the bus and set his keyboard up, and he had a folder full of songs. And he said, this got sent this week. He said, I don't even know how this song goes. He said, we have it on a cassette. We'll listen to it and we'll just see. It might make the album, but probably not. So I just reached over and I picked up the lyrics of this song and I started reading those lyrics. And Steve and I said, I've got to have this. He said, well, it might be for somebody else. We may not even use it. I said, no, I have to have this song. It was like the songwriter looked inside my soul and saw what I was dealing with and put pen to paper. And I have not sung this song much, many times since then, until about 10 months ago. My one and only brother was diagnosed with pancreatic cancer 10 months ago. He and I are 11 months apart. For 2 weeks, we're the same age. Mom and Dad didn't waste much time. I was the little brother, he was big brother. And I started singing this song 10 months ago. Because it's about trusting God. 4 weeks ago, yesterday, my brother passed. I feel numb. I'm sure you know what I'm talking about. All my life it's been Brian and Jim, or Jim and Brian. But I know this. Nowhere in God's word does he ever say, understand what I'm doing. He never says that. In fact, he says his ways are higher than our ways. His thoughts are higher than our thoughts. And here's what I've come to realize. Every single person is going through something. Matter of fact, I heard a preacher say years ago, if you're not in the middle of a storm now, you've either come out of one or you're headed into one. And the older I get, the more that I realize that's true. Our mom, I told you a moment ago, she's devastated. I guess she had a really bad day Tuesday. I was on the ocean and thankful for family members that went and spent the day with her. And I want to share this with you that might be struggling to trust God in a different situation. Maybe it's a financial situation or a health situation or a relationship situation. The reason I know that we can trust God with our situation, because He's trustworthy and He's good. We don't have to understand it all, because I certainly don't understand. My brother left 4 grown sons, 3 daughters-in-law, 5 grandchildren. And he loves his grandbabies the way I love my grandbabies. So if this song is not for anybody else, it's probably for me. Because there are days I'm angry, and there's days that I just want to pull the covers over my head and stay in bed. I'm sure you've been there and you know. But I want to share this song because I've never trusted you like I'm going to trust you now. If we could just learn to lay our burdens. In fact, the Bible says to cast our cares upon Him. And you know what? That's a fishing term. That cast, the word cast, the fishing term. Back in those days when Jesus and the disciples were fishermen, It would take 4 and 5 men to pick up this net and throw it, cast it. And that's exactly what Jesus wants us to do with our cares, is cast them all on Him, for He cares for us. Listen to this song and let it bless you. It says, I've never trusted you like I'm going to trust you now.
Yeah.
change, but I'm giving you the Bible. Lord, I lay my weapons down, and I've never really trusted you like I'm gonna do right now.
Father, thank you for being faithful to us. And God, there's somebody here, and I'm sure there is, that are struggling with just trusting you. God, first of all, forgive us for doubting you. Forgive us for ever wondering if you care, because we know that you do. Oftentimes, God, it's hard for us to get our mind and our heart together on the same page with that. But we know that you care and you love us. Father, give us strength. Give us your peace. Give us your comfort as we are learning to trust you, learning to lean on you more every day. Thank you for being patient with us and loving us in spite of our weaknesses and our failures. Thank you for being God. Thank you for loving us enough to send Jesus to die on the cross for our sins. May be our comforter. Be our strength. Your word says, God, you are a strong tower where the righteous can run into. Give us your peace. We pray this in Jesus' name. All God's people said, amen. I'm going to turn it over to Stephen.
Brian, I was a little concerned when you invited me to come up and get on the piano with you. I know it's not going to hold me, and then you add you on there, it's not going to hold both of us. Have you enjoyed Brian tonight? One of the things that I love about Brian and his ministry is that he just does not come to sing and perform, but he comes to minister. And certainly what he has done for us tonight is ministered to a lot of us in a lot of different ways. Been very uplifting, but also to share his own personal hurts. And it's a reminder that even though, Brian, you're a rock star in my eyes, you're up there, he's just common folk like the rest of us. And needs prayers, needs help, and needs the Lord like the rest of us do. And it's a good reminder. We've been reminded of that tonight. And I love that he reminded us that nowhere in God's word does it say, hey, this is what I'm doing necessarily. He doesn't always give us every answer to all the questions that we have. And I find comfort in that, knowing that he is the answer to every question that we could ever have. And when we know the Lord in that way, it helps to manage the pain. Brian, someone said to my family when my grandma, and I never forgot this, that it's in knowing the promises of tomorrow that help you to manage the pain of the present. And it doesn't mean the pain of the present goes away, but it's manageable. And as believers, we will not be defeated. And when the devil tries to use those pains to attack us, he doesn't know who he's messing with, and he have a believer. We will not be defeated because God is our answer. And so all of us need to be encouraged with what Brian has shared with us tonight, that when we do go through storms, that we have a solid foundation, and that because we know where we're going and what it costs God to get us there, to redeem us, Well, there's nothing that this old world can throw at us to defeat us. Maybe knock us down for a time, but the Lord is there to pick us up and to carry us. So we've been uplifted and reminded of that tonight. And I'm so glad that guys like Brian are in this ministry where they go to churches to uplift and encourage believers, because that prepares us to go out to a world that doesn't yet know what we know. And it reminds us that we've got a job to do. Until the Lord returns, we need to be telling another soul how they can find the Lord, and more importantly, how they too can be redeemed, so they have the strength and the peace and the hope that we have. Tonight you have an opportunity not only to be ministered to, but if the Lord lays it on your heart, we always want to open up and offer a free will offering. If you want to support Ryan's ministry, we invite you to do that. There's no obligation to do that, but he at least needs a little bit of money to make it back to Ohio. So I've done my part, by the way. One thing that I know about Brian, another thing that we have in common, how many of you remember the old soda pop known as Big Red? This man tears a bottle of Big Red up like nobody I've seen. So he's got six bottles up the back of my office.
Can I tell a story on that?
You sure can.
Okay, the reason I love Big Red so much, I grew up loving it, and if I was good in church when I was a kid, on the way home, my dad would stop at this little mom-and-pop grocery store and buy me a Big Red. Now, I didn't have very many Big Red growing up because I was rarely good in church. So now that I'm an adult, I even got my grandbabies loving Big Red. So, you know, instead of doing the Frosty Mug root beer, we do Frosty Mug Big Red. Oh, yeah. So.
So we're going to have a word of prayer. I'm going to ask our guys that have been asked to help take up the offering, if you'll come on up, stand here with me, and we'll have a word of prayer. Brian's going to sing one more for us, and I'll let him tell a little bit more about this, but I always like to remind people, if you like Brian a lot and our other artists, you have an opportunity to take them home with you. Okay, and that'll be not physically with him, but you can take his CDs and different things. I'll let him tell a little bit more about that. But you have an opportunity there. Let's go ahead and let me invite you to stand just so we get a seventh inning stretch here. And that also give you an opportunity to snatch a dollar or two out of your neighbor's wallet. Heavenly Father, thank you for the evening that we've had here, an uplifting night through gospel music and Brian, who has sung your praise and reminded us believers of our home in heaven. And one day, Father, we don't know exactly what it's going to be like, but we're going to fly away. It's all because of what you have done to redeem us. We've also been reminded that in our tough storms that we go through, that if we trust you more, you are the answer. And we can find our peace, we can find our hope and comfort in you. And while we don't always understand every single thing that happens and why it happens, Father, we trust in you because we love you. And we love you because you first loved us. And you have redeemed us and saved us. And so it is worth trusting you. Father, we pray for Brian, his ministry. We pray for the offering that's being collected. We pray that that would go to help to further his ministry as he promotes the kingdom of God. We pray that many lives will be touched through that ministry. In your son's name, we pray these things. Amen. You may be seated.
Thank you for giving the offering tonight. This is how to provide my family is through our ministry. Like Stephen said, we do have a table over there. Everything I'll sung or will sing is on a CD over there. We have five different CDs. We have two that we never had here before. So I had somebody this morning say, I've got all your stuff, and these two are brand new. One is called Healing. It has the song I'll Fly Away that I did tonight, Goodness of God. We have another one, that song, I Never Trusted You More, and Put Your Hand in the Hand of the Man is on that newest one. But anyway, any one CD over there is for $15, any two for $20. Get all five of our CDs for only $35 tonight. We also have them on thumb drive if you don't have a CD player. And we also are carrying our bracelets. This bracelet is brand new. It says, God is in my story. And I love that. It's a great witness wear. You get to tell people that God is in your story, in your life story. And also we have a different nugget bracelet. But we take cash checks. We do debit cards. So we stop by and pick up some music, take it home with you. Pay for it first, but take some music home with you. I appreciate that. And one final thing I'll sing. We go on a Singing at Sea cruise every single year. It's one full week of the best in gospel music. Yvonne and I go. About 25 other artists go. It's one full week. They close the bars. They close the casinos. And in those big lounges and where they normally do those Broadway type shows. That's where all the gospel music is. Some of the best Bible preachers in America are going to be a part of the cruise. And we have some brochures back there, but we don't have the new brochure for 2025. But you can still take a brochure of this cruise. And if you are interested in going, you can call ahead and reserve your room. We'd love to be your host on the Sinking in the Sea cruise next year. You have a blast. We sail out of Port Canaveral. It'd be January of next year and get back in. You won't even miss church. So we leave on a Monday, get back on a Saturday, okay? So I'm going to do this final song. Well, a song I fell in love with. My wife wanted me to sing it. I didn't like it at the time, but I do now, okay? Great message.
Oh, I have days I lose the fight. Try my best, but just don't get it right.
Y'all have those days?
Where I talk a talk that I don't walk and miss the moments right before my eyes. Somebody with a hurt that I could have helped. Somebody with a hand that I could have held. When I just can't see past myself, Lord, help me be a little more like mercy, a little more like grace, a little more like kindness, goodness, love, and faith, a little more like patience, a little more like peace, a little more like Jesus, a little less like me.
Oh, yeah!
A little less like me.
All this is first.
There's no denying I had changed, cause I've been saved from who I used to be. Oh, thank you, Lord. But even at my best, I must confess, I still need help to see the way you see. Somebody with a hurt that I could have helped. Somebody with a hand that I could have held. But I just can't see past myself. Lord, help me be a little more like mercy, a little more like grace, a little more like kindness, goodness, love, and faith. A little more like patience, a little more like peace, a little more like Jesus, a little less like me. Whoa. A little more like kindness, goodness, love, and faith. A little more like patience, a little more like peace. A little more like Jesus, oh, a little less like me. A little more like living, everything I preach. A little more like Jesus, a little less like me. A little less like me. Oh, yeah. I wanna be a little more like Jesus. A little less like me.
Oh, yeah! Is that a great song? Great song. There you go, Brent.
Back to the table there. So let's go ahead and stand one more time and give him one more big hand. If it's all right, Alex, can I ask you to come up here and close us out in prayer? But he shared a very important message that he had received from one of his neighbors about the Super Bowl that's coming up. And we might have some takers in this group. We didn't have anybody in our men's group, but I'll give it to you. And then after you give that announcement, give a closing word.
Then you'll get a break.
Break what you just did. Well, it really is a good opportunity for somebody, and I haven't had a response yet, but I just got a text on my phone today. A buddy of mine bought 2 tickets to the Super Bowl, 50-yard line, box seats, paid $2,500, $3,000 a piece for them. Totally forgot when he bought them a year ago. It's the same day as his wedding.
Oh.
Yeah. So the text says he's looking for somebody to take his place. So it's at 3:00 at St. Michael's Church. She's 5'4". Her name is Sheila. And she'll be the one in the white dress. Brian, you got out of here just in time.
Yes.
Hey, let's thank the Lord for a good night. Father, what a privilege to be able to fill our hearts with songs that praise you and lift us up at the same time. We appreciate the ministry of Brian and that he was able to come and share with us tonight. We thank you that it's not just music and entertainment, but there's special words that feed our soul, because you have called us to yourself. You have helped us to understand and appreciate and hang on to the words that we've heard tonight. We thank you for the songs of encouragement. We thank you for the songs of praise. We thank you for the songs of rejoicing. And we thank you for the songs of hope. And to that end, we thank you for the hope that we have in our Lord Christ. We thank you for the night we've had. Pray your continued blessing on Brian as he travels in the future, in future days. We pray for his wife, that you would lift her up and embrace her and cause healing in that regard. These things we ask in your name. Amen.
Amen.
And I'll give you that guy's phone number.